It becomes very important, two major things when you start a startup is how unique is your idea first, how unique is there much of a competition in your own industry? You need to understand that. It's not like, today I get a thought, this is an amazing idea. You need to validate it with your friends, do a small, testing in the market, ask, do a survey testing, whether the idea that you think is unique, does people also resonate with that or not? First, the validation of the idea is very important. Second is, what problem are you solving? Is there a problem like, hand sanitizer and mask was a problem when COVID hit? It's always about hitting the rod when it is hot at the right time. You have to be at the right place at the right time. So when COVID hit, a normal, producer or a manufacturer who might be manufacturing sanitizers and alcohol-based products or, masks could scale up there and could, because it solves a problem. So two things, validation of your idea, which is you think you are unique, but is it actually unique? And second is, what problem does it solve? On a broader scale. COVID has changed the way we look at the work, the working lifestyle, the way most of the people are working from home. So our lifestyle has changed and this will go on. It has a permanent effect. So everybody is moving online. Two avenues where you should be is, first and foremost, if you are into the business, have a good website. Without website, you don't stand out. You don't get that validation from the people that, hey, whatever you do within the circle, getting business. But if you don't have a website, you don't have a global appeal. So get first channel is your website, and you can integrate n number of things. And second, for getting good leads is LinkedIn. So that these are my two top marketing channels where, so website is where I do the pitching and global appeal kind of thing, run campaigns on it. And LinkedIn is where I generate leads from. So highly effective, tried and tested for 3 years. So I'll give you a cheat book right now. So if you have a podcast, if you think that the other person can be your client, can be your customer, and you want to crack him, just don't pitch your product directly. Ask him to come on your podcast and then softly pitch your product. Because since then, once he has done a collaboration with you, he knows you well, and then the chances of conversion getting high. So inviting in an event or a podcast, just before softly pitching your product to him is a good strategy or a tool or technique, whatever you want to say it. Pitch deck is quite common, so it's kind of old fashioned. I would say use videos more, maybe a 1 minute or a 2 minute video of expressing what your company does, what problem does your company solve or your product or service solves, and how are you unique, and makes you unique. And talking about, also it becomes very important if you are a startup that who are your team members, because that brings a lot of credibility on board, and for investors to, or probably prospect clients to get that trust, build that trust in you. So yeah, videos is a good way to tell a prospect to what all things you do, what all problems do you solve. Instead of pitch deck, go for pitch videos. Second is invite the prospective client to your podcast or any online event that you do, and then softly pitch it. Probably these two steps would definitely help you crack the client that you want to get. See, the thing is, the demand, you need to see at the demand side and the supply side. Demand is definitely increasing, so as the supply. So make sure your supply, what you deliver, is of quality. There won't be any competition problem, because there is some or the other thing for every marketer in this particular digital marketing age. And what defines is your ESP and your quality of service. Because don't follow the rest, the noise. Where you differentiate out is what is your USP, that and also the quality of, that you deliver. Because hey, when you deal in a startup ecosystem, word of mouth is very important. The client that you have worked with, he should say good things about you. Because if you deliver good service and good quality service to him, and you have a good relation with him, the word of mouth spreads like crazy, and that happy client would give you more two clients in the future. So yeah. Don't worry about competition. There is high demand, so and there is a piece of cake for everybody. You know, there are 3-4 things which I want to highlight. Either you're from Tier 1 institute like IIM, IIT, because that gives a lot of credibility for any of the investor that this guy really believes in the company and the product and service that he has, and he can scale it up. So that is one validation point. Second, show them what experience do you have. Maybe, you know, 6, 7 years, 8 years of experience, the company you work for. For you, it would be like IIM, IIT. For us, none of us are from IIM and IIT, but what you could show is the years of experience. Third most important thing is the numbers. So until now, from the start of the company till now, what is the revenue like? How is your growth happening? Once you show that number that we are sustainable and we are growing at a normal pace and we have these many products, so show them the numbers that you are growing and then ask for it. And number fourth is your vision should be very clear about where do you want to go. If you got all these sorted in, then probably there are more chances that investors or angel investors might spend in you. And also one more add-on bonus tip I am going to give is most of the investors, they invest in product-based companies. So if you are a service-based company, probably think about any product in your long-term vision. That might help. When you are at the starting, you don't have to really think about a lot of things, right? Since I had a startup earlier, I was all over the place, and a lot of people could actually relate to this. When you start, there is invoicing, there is leads, you need to nurture the leads, you need to convert them, you need to find leads. Wherein all this happening, the delivery gets impacted. And delivery is the prime thing. Delivery and servicing of your client becomes the, once your client is onboarded, delivery and the kind of customer experience that you show is the main part. So that is where most of the startups do miss out. So yeah, it's very simple. When you are starting up, like you are not entering into the growth phase. We have still not entered into the growth phase and scaling up. Maybe next year we would do that, but it becomes very important. You know, it doesn't matter how high you go. It matters how long you go. So that is what you need to focus on first. Second, check on your basics, like your cost is in place, your clientele is in place. And third, start with your own Rolodex. What I mean by Rolodex is, you know, your connections that you have built in the industry, if you are experienced enough, start, make them as your customer because they know you. So the people whom you know, make them your customer first. Try and test out the product and services that you think that you need to scale up and want to bring an empire, creating an empire. But before creating an empire, you sell them your product and services, help them in testing it out and get better. And once you enter the growth phase, you have numbers ready, you have something to show to the investor, pitch the idea to the investor. If he likes it, you get the investor. Thank you. Srikanth is hardcore fan of Seth Godin. Seth Godin is a marketing legend. The way he market is kind of crazy. So even his purple cow, it came in a milk box, milk carton. The way he packaged was very different. So he's the god of marketing. We all three founders have a whole, you know, it's our wish to meet him and, you know, work with him sometime, someday. So business related, I would definitely suggest marketing related books. I would definitely suggest Purple Cow by Seth Godin. It's also one of my favorite books. And few key takeaways are how you could be a brave marketer. The kind of marketing efforts you do have a positive impact on other people, like because the good marketing is something which is the need of the hour. In an age of a digital era and the social media and so much of noise, with all people coming on to the internet and they're just thinking about all the trending stuff and putting their videos up, with all so many noise on the internet, how you can differentiate with good marketing is what you need to look into. If suppose you and me, I gave you the Purple Cow book, I gifted you. Some third person saw it and asked you, man, this is great. That's where the marketing is. You know, how you would make the third person speak about you or intrigue you to, you know, say something about me or who gifted it or what is it? That's marketing for you. So that is what the Purple Cow for marketing is. It has its own pros and cons. Job is like you just sit for a month and easily you get a salary credited at the end. You see that message at every month on, you know, 30th and 31st, and you are like, okay, cool. Entrepreneurship is a 360 degree approach. You can scale like crazy, you can go down like crazy every day. The opportunities would hit you. And more than opportunities, there would be a lot of failures. You have to be mentally very strong to take up entrepreneurship. You know, people say, just quit job. It's bullshit. No, nobody believe it now. You know, in terms of start, you need not to quit your job. Start with your side hustle. And eventually, once you see fair bit of revenue coming out from your side hustle, you can then plan to go move full time. So I think with entrepreneurship, it's a 360 degree. Opportunities and failures, except both opportunities and failures, they would come anytime. But the freedom that you get comes a little later once your hard work is in place and setting up the firm and company or product or whatever you want to set up. First, a lot of hard work goes into it. So you need founder, you need directors of the company, you need your GST number sorted, you need the initial 1 lakh rupees sorted for your company, and you need to have a good CA or CS. You know, you need to file all the compliance which goes on. So touch wood, we luckily in the early stages, we actually got, either you can go through, if you get investor in the early stage of your company, that's really good, they could sort it out for you. But if you don't, like, you know, any of the bootstrap company, and most of the bootstrap company like us, you Google it, you check the process, how it works. That is what we did. And finally, we reached out to a firm and a friend of mine who is also CA and CS. So we asked, this is what we are planning and what are the legalities? You take care of the legalities, company filing, etc., etc., and how to get registered, what is trademark, how do you get your GST number, because if you want to go global, nobody will work with you until and unless you would have, I mean, people would work as a freelancer, but you know, to set a firm entity, you need to have a GST number and all the compliance sorted, and you don't want government putting you under fines and all. You don't want to pay them, right? So I mean, you know, you don't have to miss out on deadlines. So make sure that your legal team is sorted, at least speak to CA and CS, and there are a few things that you can take consideration: initial capital invested, the number of partners that you have, and if you are coming, because investor will come and they will take the equity. So make sure that you are prepared that how much equity you want to sell it out to the investor, because whatever works out for you, I mean, just discuss it, go Google it, discuss it with your CS friend, and have an initial capital of 1 lakh rupees.